When CDs launched, it was hailed quite rightly as a revolutionary new music format. Music was crystal clear and it was a handy small disc format. It was only 12 centimeters wide and could hold over an hour of music. TV shows hyped the CD's ability to resist dust and scratches, which were both problems with LPs. It could be played over and over again and the disc wouldn't degrade, and every single time it was played there was no background noise, no wow and flutter, almost no distortion, and a high dynamic range. This was revolutionary in an age when LP's quality got worse with wear. It was so revolutionary that they hyped just how indestructible it was. I remember Tomorrow's World putting Jam on it, but I think that's a bit of an urban legend, because when I search on Tomorrow's World Jam, I get a Tomorrow's World clip about compact discs, but it doesn't have any Jam or anything like that. So it seems I'm not alone that there is this sort of whole thing about Tomorrow's World and Jam, but apparently they never put Jam on a disc. But they did scratch it up, as you can see from this clip. And the idea being that CDs were somehow indestructible. The only clip I can find that shows something to do with spreading things all over a disc to show how indestructible it is this clip from BBC Breakfast Time. They show its indestructibility by smearing honey all over it and then pouring coffee all over it. Then they give it a quick wipe down without removing all the honey and then shove it in the new £500 CD player. Probably not the best thing to do. But is it true? Can you pour coffee and smear honey and maybe Jam on the CD, give it a quick wipe and then have it play? Let's find out. Okay, here goes with the test. Will CDs work after you put coffee and honey on them? Well, first of all, I've bought a CD player from Goodwill, from a charity shop, because I don't trust this thing. And secondly, I've bought three CDs that I don't mind destroying, because these are Classical Marches, a Reader's Digest CD, and songs from Ray Conniff, which I grew up with and really detest. But just to prove that everything's fine, first of all, here is a disc from 1984. Just to prove that discs from a long time ago will still play. This is a disc that's, what, almost 40 years old now. So let's open the really cool mechanism on this disc player and put the disc in and close it up. And will it play? Will it copyright match? That's the more important thing. And it plays perfectly. Perfect. So, it's a working CD player. Discs from over 40 years old will play, or almost 40 years old will play. So, anyway, will they play when you put coffee and honey on them? Well, let's start with this disc, the Reader's Digest disc. So first of all, it's actually a really good disc. I think someone bought this disc, as most people buy them from Reader's Digest, and then realized it was a big mistake, because these are terrible songs and terrible discs. But it's absolutely pristine, it's perfect, it looks really good. So anyway, let's take a look at this disc. Does it play? Well, it does play because I've just tested it, but I'll prove it plays. You two can hear the terrible music from Reader's Digest. Yes, there you go, it plays. And it's awful. So, test one, put coffee on it when this thing has finally opened. Okay, piping hot coffee I've just made, pouring all over the disc. Ha 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 ha, that's probably not a good idea. Okay, I think in the Breakfast Time thing, they may have used cold coffee, which was probably a good idea. Okay, wipe the disc, try and get rid of all of this really horrible coffee all over the disc. And will it play? Well, it looks pretty good. Okay, put it in, see if it plays. Unsurprisingly, it still plays. That's not a great shock. But honey, I've got coffee all over this CD player. Okay, coffee and then, what was it? It was honey, then it was coffee. Okay, so let's try the honey.
pour that all over the disc, get it nice and on there, and spread it, because you've got to spread honey, apparently. I mean, I guess it's toast. This was what the breakfast time challenge was going to go for. Okay, we've got honey all over this thing and all over this knife. Okay, honey all over it. And pour the incredibly hot coffee all over the disc. To be honest, this doesn't do anything because the honey's all over it anyway, so it doesn't really make a lot of difference. Now, what they did in the breakfast time clip, now I've got honey everywhere, is they gave it a light wiping and then put it in the disc player. I'm not going to do that because I'm going to do that at the end and then destroy this disc player. But I'm going to try and wipe this off completely and then try and play it again. So I've cleaned the disc. Disc is pretty spotlessly clean. If you can see that, it's pretty good, both sides. So the CD test, will it play after coffee and honey? Of course it plays it, no problem at all. I mean, it's still as awful as ever, but it plays it. So next step, tomorrow's world, everyone thinks that tomorrow's world used jam on discs. Will jam work? And also they scratch their disc, so we could also try that. There is coffee everywhere here. It's just gone everywhere. So anyway, we'll give the Reader's Digest disc a bit of a rest. Interestingly, there were two discs that I found at the charity shop. One with these classical marches, which of course sounds terrible. And the second one was patriotic marches with lots of American marches and things like that on. And I thought, I can't really destroy a disc with American marches on. So I got this one. And what is the first march that's on the disc? Yes, it's the Star Spangled Banner. So I'm trying not to destroy patriotic discs, and I get patriotic discs. There's a lot of drum rolls at the start of these things. Yeah, anyway, they're terrible. Marches should be discarded and put in room 101. They are absolutely terrible. But you know what's even more terrible than marches? Ray Conniff. Ray Conniff is potentially the worst music I have ever heard. Anyway, let's go back, look at the disc. Disc is absolutely fine. Again, nobody wanted to play this disc because of course they didn't. So, jam. Jam. Jam we made ourselves, blackberry jam. Hopefully, lots of pips in it and things like that. Let's try that and see what happens. Okay, spread liberal bits of jam all over the disc, get it in all those crevices. Okay, just put it in here for now. Yuck. Nice jam though. I would highly recommend making your own jam, particularly blackberry jam when it's blackberry season. It is really good stuff. Equal weight blackberries to sugar, surprisingly. Because it's basically sugar. It's just flavoured sugar, that's what jam is. Okay, this is, again, pretty disgusting, but we've got pretty much all the jam off. Here we go. Let's take this terrible disc, which I didn't play to you before, but honestly, I did play it before, and it's terrible. I played it to Mrs. Big Car, and she said, "This is quite nice, we should listen to this music." No, we shouldn't. It's awful. Will it play? Drum roll, a march drum roll. And yes, it plays, and it is as awful as you would think. It's got such wonderful classics as I'd Like to Teach the World to Sing, and Lara's theme from Dr. Zhivago, which everybody put at that time. Yes, okay, it plays after coffee and honey, very hot coffee, and jam, works perfectly. But this isn't what you wanted to see, is it? Actually, one more test before we do the final destructive test, which is what happens when you scratch it. As we all know, discs don't do very well with scratches. So, first of all, let's move all this out of the way. And move the jam and the honey and the coffee out of the way. To be honest, I'm going to give the Marches the scratch test because I have nothing against America. I really like America, and this is not meant to be anything to do with America, but actually this is a little bit scratched up already. It's certainly not the most pristine of discs, but anyway, we have a scouring pad and we have one of these other scouring pads. So let's scour this up good. Oh man, that's really making a mess of it. Okay, so that's that. That's made a nice mess of that disc, as you can probably see here. It's not looking too good. And then we'll try the heavy duty scourer and give that one a go. I seem to think Kieran Prendeville only did a bit of it and then tried it, but of course it wouldn't matter. It would do it. It would mess it up even if it was only part of a disc. Okay, so we've messed it up good. Will this March disc still work? And I'm thinking a lot of you who have discs and have scratched your discs or have tried a heavily scratched disc will know the answer to this question. And it's having problems. Have we finally destroyed this most awful of discs? It's not happy. It's really not happy. It's thinking and thinking and thinking, and yes, it's not working. So yes, don't scratch a disc because they don't work. But then if you've had CDs, you know that. But then if you've had CDs, you haven't been pouring coffee and honey and putting jam all over them either. So at least you've learnt a little bit of something anyway. So this disc will no longer work. It is finally dead. I mean, I could try cleaning it, but I don't think it's really going to work. Let's try a quick clean to see if it works. Okay, I've given it a quick soapy clean. I don't have high hopes for this, but then again, all of you who have had scratch discs and have tried to make them work also know it's very hard to bring them back again. Wow, it read the contents of the disc. Okay, maybe there you go, there's the answer. Give it a quick soapy clean. But will it play? It's having problems, it's not happy, it's not enjoying it. No, it's definitely not happy. It read the contents, but that's about it, I think. No! We've got it playing! Salute now! It's the American National Anthem! America is back from the dead! Yes! It's not happy though. It's just having a lot of problems trying to read this disc, but it is sort of reading it. If you were desperate to play a disc, then this might work, but it's pretty terrible. Okay, we're not getting much more out of it, but we did get the first track. Okay, moving on. So finally, let's try the destruction test. So what they did in the breakfast time clip was they put honey on it, they put coffee on it, and then they basically put it straight back in the disc player. And that's probably not going to do it a lot of good. And I'm going to use the Reader's Digest disc for this because I don't like this disc at all. To be honest, I might say I really hate this Ray Conniff disc, but secretly there's a bit of nostalgia for this disc, so I am going to put it to one side. put it in the comments if you want this disc destroyed. But certainly, I think we're going to destroy not just this disc. Actually, the disc will be fine. I think we're going to destroy the CD player. Because what we're going to do, we're going to recreate the breakfast time test. We're going to put honey on the disc. Then we're going to put coffee on the disc, which won't do any difference at all. Then we're going to give it a light wipe. And as you saw in the clip, there was still honey on the disc. And we're going to put it in the disc player, and it's going to be an awful mess because it's going to spin round, honey's going to go everywhere. But anyway, we're going to find out. We're going to have fun because that's fun. Okay, number one, it's time for honey. So put the honey on the disc. This disc is sick of getting honey on it, but it is all in the name of, well, not science. This isn't science, but it's all in the name of fun. Okay, right. It's got a little bit of jam on there as well, but why not? It's breakfast time. You have a bit of honey. You have a bit of jam. I get it all over my hands, and hopefully this coffee has cooled down by now. Here we go. Well, yeah, it's not bad. It's not burning my fingers now, which is a good thing. Okay, right. Let's lightly wipe it off. God, this is everywhere. Oh no, this is not going to go well. Okay, yeah, there's still... you can't see this very well. I'm not good at doing stuff to camera. Okay, I've lightly wiped it off, but I need to maybe get a bit more off. It is just disgusting. Okay, let's try a bit more. And it's everywhere. It's on the front, it's on the back. Oh no, this is disgusting. Okay, well, I've done more than lightly wipe it off, but quite frankly, there's honey all over this thing. It's just a honey disaster. Okay, time for the moment of truth. Poor old CD player. It's a nice CD player. It even has Bluetooth. So it's not that old. But, yeah, no one wants CD players anymore. Well, we've closed it, and it's not very happy. It's not even trying to spin the disc up. What is it doing? Let's open it. It's just sitting there not doing anything. What is going on with this disc? The disc is still in there. Okay, let's try again. Let's see if it does anything. I am disgusting. I'm covered in honey. It's not even trying. I wonder if this disc player has a honey mode where it said, ah, you've tried the honey and coffee test. I'm not that smart. I am that smart. I'm not even going to bother spinning the disc up because it's going to destroy me. Maybe they put that in chips in CD players. The honey and coffee test. Okay, there's your answer. If you put honey and then some coffee on a disc and then don't bother to wipe it properly, it doesn't play in the CD player. Oh, that is disgusting. I'm just going to put that in there. So as this CD player has obviously a honey and coffee mode to it that doesn't allow it to play discs that have been destroyed with honey and coffee, maybe it'll just play a normal disc. Let's try Ray Conniff again and see if we'll actually play this terrible nostalgic music. No. I don't think we have a honey and coffee mode. I think we've actually destroyed the CD player. The CD player is not happy. So I took the CD player over to try and clean it, and this is what the inside of the CD player looked like. So I gave it a quick cleaning, and then let's try it again and see if we can play a disc. As you can see, when I took the CD player and tried to wash it, there was sticky residue all over the inside of the CD player. So I tried to improve it. I've taken it all off the CD, and the CD's fine. Shouldn't do that. But let's see. Now we've cleaned it, will it actually play? Now we've cleaned the CD player, will the CD player actually play? And no, it's not very happy. Even after I cleaned it, it's not very happy. So that's a lesson for you. If you have CDs and you want to put honey and coffee on them, make sure you take all the honey and coffee off before you put it in your expensive CD player, because it doesn't like honey. I think it's the honey, not the coffee, to be honest. But it's not a happy thing. I think if I took it apart and cleaned it properly, it would probably be okay, but I'm not going to do that. Maybe in a follow-up video, if enough of you want me to open the CD player and try and clean it, maybe I'll do that. But it's not a happy CD player at the moment. And the good news is that I still have my Reader's Digest CD, yay, and my Ray Conniff CD. Oh, the wonderful, nostalgic, terrible music of Ray Conniff is still there to enjoy. You won't believe how much honey was on this table after I had to clean it up. Anyway, it's a little bit later. I thought I would show you that these two CDs still work, and presumably the marching one will fail in a CD player that I actually care about, this JVC that I bought quite a few years ago. So first of all, the wonderful Ray Conniff CD. So let's try that one. And yes, it's still awful, but it does play. Secondly, the Reader's Digest CD that I gave, a lot of aggro and grief to. Let's see if this one will still play. Looking good. Oh, it's not happy. It's not playing. Whoa! Have we discovered something? If you give a CD a lot of aggro, it won't play. So this has had coffee and honey and jam on it, and it's refusing to play after a good cleaning. Maybe it's just this CD player's decided that it doesn't want to play anything that's of terrible quality. Let's try that again. Oh, there you go. Now it's playing. There was just a little smudge on it, maybe from cleaning. But no, it's working just fine. And yes, why did anybody want to buy Reader's Digest CDs? I don't understand it. Awful, disgusting things. Finally, the the marching CD, which has had a lot of abuse. It really has. Poor old marching CD. But do people really like marches? Do they? It's not playing in this CD player either, so yes, that CD is definitely dead.
In the early days of compact discs, they were seen as indestructible compared to cassettes and LPs, which were relatively fragile. As you saw, I can play an almost 40-year-old CD and it's as good as the day that it was pressed. In the early 1980s, that was seen as revolutionary, but that's not to say CDs are indestructible. Scratches, as you saw, were the bane of CDs, but many discs, including laser discs and game CDs, have suffered from disc rot. That's oxidization of the metallic layer that has the data on it, and also adhesives that hold the disc together can break down over time. Metal Gear Solid Twin Snakes for the GameCube is now almost impossible to find on eBay because the manufacturing processes for the discs, in particular for that disc, made many of them fail. And if you've used cheap CDRs to archive your music or data or other things, you may find that in just a few years they won't play. Ask me how I know. But some disc makers have discs that they claim will last for up to 1,000 years, like these discs that I got from M-Disc. I've had these for 9 years so far, and so far they're holding up, but your mileage may vary. So what can you do to protect yourself from disc rot? Well, you can back up your discs every few years, and also don't trust manufacturers' claims that their discs will store data for 1,000 years. Back up regularly and keep multiple copies. When CDs launched, people were smarting from the cassette 8-track format war, and they were in the middle of a video cassette format war. So a lot of these reviews of compact discs on TV were really focusing on the fact that the CDs weren't another format war battle, and that was a big positive for them. They even predicted what would come next.
At least until someone perfects a method of putting Beethoven's Ninth on a silicon chip. Don't laugh. I'm assured that that day, in fact, is not too far off.
Well, it's a couple of days later, and I thought I'd give you a quick update on this CD player that's had a lot of abuse. It's working now, so presumably things have dried out or cleaned out or whatever, but anyway, things are working. It's still got a very slow CD tray, but I suppose that's by design. And as you can see, it closes, it starts a disc, and it plays again. So yes, it's working again. This is actually not a bad CD player. Again, I got this from a charity shop, and you can buy CD players now for next to nothing. It has Bluetooth, it has a radio on it, which I discovered later on, so you can play radio out of it. It has an aux input, there's a 3.5mm jack on the back that you can use, and as I said before, it has Bluetooth. Apparently that's NFC, not sure what NFC does. And it also has, if you turn it into standby mode, it has a clock, which I'm yet to work out how to set the clock. I've tried pressing every single button and it won't work. But it's a nice tidy little CD player, and it, you know, gives a good amount of volume for what it is. It has USB charging on the top, so it's got a little bit of everything and works very well.
If you want to hear more about compact discs, I've done a video about the SPARS code, that's the AAD and DDD and things like that you saw on compact discs. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.